Hello traders, this is Elizabeth Bilugina and you are watching Daily Stock Market Review by Tradimo. As you can see, S&P 500 index futures is trading sideways in the area of 2815 on Thursday, March 28th. The market is awaiting some news about the trade relations between the United States and China. American top trade negotiator Robert Lighthizer and Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin arrived today in Beijing to resume talks. However, hopes of breakthrough are rather low currently because the United States has recently made some aggressive moves which may be regarded negatively by the Chinese side. For example, US warships made transit through Taiwan Strait, and also US encourages its partners to restrict the use of telecommunications equipment by the Huawei technology company. On the other hand, the White House economic advisor claimed that America is prepared to keep negotiating for weeks and months. This may be a bit hopeful, although the market certainly wants some resolution and no one wants the uncertainty to continue for weeks and months. As a result, we can see that stocks are under pressure. In addition, US GDP growth in the fourth quarter was revised down from 2.6% to 2.2%. So American economic growth is slowing down. The markets were already to such lower figures after the dovish message of the Federal Reserve, but still negative data is negative data, and it doesn't look like American stocks have a lot of reasons to grow right now. The near-term resistance is located around 2830, and only above this level the market will be able to retest resistance around 2870. The major support is at 28 mark, and it is guiding the way towards 2760, where we find 200-day moving average. Another important topic for the market is Brexit. On Wednesday, British lawmakers had several votes on different versions of Brexit solutions, but neither managed to gain majority, and the new vote is expected on Monday. Probably something will happen, or maybe not. We do not know, because UK Parliament has time until April 12th, and a lot of negotiations and a lot of failed votes may happen during that time. So uncertainty remains, and the sideways dynamics of the market it remains as well. This is the conclusion we may make in the current situation. If we need to tell a few words about the commodity market, and here Brent was feeling some negative pressure as Donald Trump called on OPEC countries to increase production, and US economic data, which was weaker than expected, also had a negative effect on the price. So this is another sign of market fears of limited risk sentiment, some atmosphere that is not really supporting risk assets. In the meantime, US treasuries stabilized a bit, but the yields still remain very, very low, and this is another proof that the market is having bad expectations about the future. So we can see that the current situation does not welcome the rally in stocks in any way. If we look to individual stocks, we need to have a look at Apple. Once again, no big news for today, but we can see that the stock remains under pressure, hovering above support in the area of 186.70. Decline below this level will open the way down towards a much lower level at 176. While the resistance in the short term around 190 is preventing the stock from revisiting highs around 198. Here news are the same. The presentation of Apple, which failed to give the market details about the future services Apple will introduce this year. And the fact that the company is in a lot of disputes with Qualcomm company, that is also making Apple trading under pressure, as well as the general lack of positive sentiment in the market. Have a look also at the stock of Southwest Airlines. The company reported the news that due to groundings of Boeing planes, the ticket sales declined. However, we can see that the stock manages to stay afloat and even rise during the recent days. Resistance will be located just a few dollars on the upside, around 51.50 and 53 levels. So it surely exists for the company. And JP Morgan announced that it will cut hundreds of jobs after staffing review. The stock is in negative trend as it broke a major support level recently. However, the news doesn't reflect any big problem, because these things happen sometimes from big companies. So just the general situations with lower yields is affecting the company. And if the current flag is broken to the downside, the decline will continue towards 96 level and probably lower. Thank you for your attention. This is all for today, and we wish you a good trading session. If you liked the video, subscribe to Tradimo YouTube channel.